Welcome to Descriptive Writing. My name is Miss Barrow. In last week's lesson, we learned how sensory details can be used to paint a vivid picture in the reader's mind. Yes, it can be used to describe settings, objects, characters, and action. Well, today, we are focusing on figurative language. But before we move on, let's take a look at our objectives. After this video, you will be able to do the following. List four types of figurative language. Tell the differences of various types of figurative language. Use similes, metaphors, onomatopoeias, and alliterations in descriptive writing. There are oodles of figurative language. Some examples are illusions, personifications, assonances, oxymorons, hyperboles, puns, idioms, alliterations, metaphors, onomatopoeias, and similes. But what is figurative language? Figurative language are words that differ from their literal meaning. Actually, we use them all the time. Clear as mud? Not to worry. Today, we'll be focusing on similes, metaphors, onomatopoeias, and alliterations. First, let's take a look at similes. A simile compares two things using the words like or as. For example, Monique drove her car as fast as lightning. Wow, look at that car go. Here are other examples. We have two characters, Daria on the left and a supermodel on the right. We can use the word like to make a comparison, such as, even on her tough days, Daria looks like a supermodel on a catwalk. Let's do another example. This time, we are comparing Kristen A's singing to angels using the term as. When Kristen A sings, her voice is as glorious as a heavenly host of angels. Now it's time for you to try. Look at the two pictures provided. First, we have a picture representing Junkanoo music. And the other shows candies. Think about how you can compare these two concepts in your writing. First, write a comparing sentence using the word like. And then try writing another sentence using the word as. Now, pause the video and start writing. When you are done, press play. Welcome back. Did your sentences read, Junkanoo music is sweet like candy? Or, Junkanoo music is sweet as candy? Good job. Here, the writer expressed how delightful Junkanoo music is by comparing it to something enjoyable, like candy. Let's continue. Take a close look at the character who I call Joshua. What emotion would you say he is experiencing? Hold that thought. Now, his emotion is so intense that you as a writer have decided to compare it to this animal. What's that? That's right, a grizzly bear. Now try writing a sentence to compare the two characters using a simile. Pause the video until you are done writing your two sentences. Welcome back again. How did it go? Did you write your sentences? Great. Well, these are the sentences I came up with. Joshua was as furious as a grizzly bear. Or maybe you wrote this one. Joshua was furious like a grizzly bear. Good job. Now that we have similes under our belts, let's stick a nail in metaphors. A metaphor says that something is like something else. Let's take this sentence for example. Mr. Butler is a pig. Notice that we never use the words like or as. But I have a question. Is Mr. Butler really a pig? No. But the writer may want to illustrate that his behavior is equal to that of a pig. Let's take a look at these photos. On the left, we have Robin. And on the right, there's a shooting star. Now look carefully in the middle. There's an equal sign. This suggests that Robin is equal to a shooting star. Let's see how this looks in writing. Robin is a shooting star. Now, is Robin really a shooting star? Not literally, but in this setting, this metaphor suggests that she is excelling academically. Whoa, cool! Kendrick is skydiving. But his friends Nelson and Jackson, on the other hand, planned to go skydiving, but they were petrified. The average writer may say that these guys are scary. However, the creative writer would say Jackson and Nelson are total chickens. They were too petrified to go skydiving with Kendrick. Now it's your turn. Create a sentence using a metaphor to describe Bill's crying. Pause the video and write your sentence now. Remember to press play when you're done. I'm sure that your sentence rocks. Here's a possible sentence to describe Bill. Bill's tears were a river flowing down his cheeks. Here, Bill's tears are being referred to as a river. Up next is onomatopoeia. An onomatopoeia is a sound written out as a word. Let's have a listen of this sing-along by Jolene Griffith.
It's a drip, drop, fizzle, pop, sizzling song. It's a beep, beep, vroom, vroom, zoom along. It's a zip, zap, snip, snap, ping, ping, pong. It's an onomatopoeia sing along. Cluck, cluck.
Cluck, cluck.
Bah, bah.
Bah, bah.
Cock-a-doodle-doo.
Cock-a-doodle-doo.
Oink, oink, nay, nay, quack, quack, moo.
Wow! That video was loaded with onomatopoeias. Onomatopoeias allow for interesting sensory details. Can you guess which one? Yes, sound. You are absolutely correct. While an onomatopoeia can stand on its own, such as these examples, ring, gulp, and boom, onomatopoeias can also be used in detailed sentences. Here's an example. Sheriff barks at Johnny for leaving his dirty clothes all over the living room floor. Bark is used to express how frustrated Sarah is. It's time to practice. Take 5 minutes to fill in the blanks with the most appropriate use of an onomatopoeia. Pause the video to practice and press play when you're done. You may start now. Time's up. Let's check your answers. Number one, the flood water gushed through the town. Number two, after scuba diving in Exuma, Jayla was buzzing with excitement. Number three, at night, the wind was howling in the darkness. Number four, a deer's teeth chattered as she stood in the snow. Number five, the leaves crunched under a cage's feet as he walked through the woods. Did you get 5 out of 5? Superrific! Snap, crackle, pop. Let's zoom on down to alliteration. Sally sells seashells by the seashore. That's a tongue twister. You try saying that 3 times without stopping. This is called alliteration, which is a repeat of the same sound at the beginning of each word or closely connected words. What does this example sound like? Yes, you heard the S sound. Take a crack at this activity. 3 pictures have been provided to spark your creativity. A caterpillar, river, and a snake. Using alliteration, write a sentence for each picture. Remember, think about the sound you want to be repeated. You know the drill. Pause the video, record your answers, and press play when you're done. Let's look at the examples I came up with. The caterpillar crawled carefully toward the cabbage leaf. The raging river roared relentlessly. The slippery snake slowly slithered across the scorching sand. We have explored similes, metaphors, onomatopoeias, and alliterations. Now let's see how these examples of figurative language can be combined in a descriptive paragraph. Here's an example as to how this can be used in your descriptive writing. I call it junk canoe explosion. With banging drums and tooting whistles, the excitement of culture exploded during the Boxing Day parade. The streets were adorned with a kaleidoscope of jaw-dropping costumes. The brass section was a beast. They blew their horns like hurricane force winds, driving an army of spectators to their feet. With their faces extravagantly painted, dancers flapped their wings like butterflies while prancing to the therapeutic sounds of music. The rhythm was so contagious, fans ecstatically bounced from side to side. The crowd's roars really rocked Rosen Square. Not a soul was motionless. The entertainment satisfied their appetites. This was evident by the unified echoes chanting, "It over! It over!" Can you taste the sweet victory? Make no mistake, in the Bahamas, junk canoe is life. Can you identify where the figurative language was used in this paragraph? How about the word of the week? If not, pause the video and take a second to identify each example along with the type of figurative language represented. Pause now. I'm sure that you did an excellent job identifying the figurative language examples in this paragraph, and also the word of the week, contagious. Can you remember what it means? Yes, it means that something can be transmitted from one thing or person to the next. Let's recap. Descriptive writing can be improved by using similes, metaphors, onomatopoeias, and alliteration. It helps with great word choice and also paints the picture in a reader's mind. Happy writing! Thanks for joining.